installation, all right? If you get out there and you see this guy tilted this way, what's happening? What's going to happen? What do you think?
And the light up with the gas.
The heat's going to come
up. Yeah. The heat's going to ride back. If you have a filter here, eventually that filter is going to get burned out. If you have a hole, eventually it's going to start melting that hole. When you get out there, take a look there, make sure it's at least 1 to 3 degrees bent downward. And this hole doesn't come back out and kind of tie to the chain. Make sure it goes away from the hot tub. Kind of like the hot tub. So heat rises up. So anything above here should be a metal chain. Should be a rubber hole to come back out.
So, as you'll see, there's a bin on the front of that heater. You know, that's all the excess heat coming out. But I do that, I see that a lot. I go out to these farms, and that hose is looped back over there, and it's sit tied to that chain up to the ceiling. That is a real no-no. I mean, with the way insurance is anymore, and especially insurance up here in Minnesota, and the fires we've had over the past few years, you don't want to get caught doing that. Your insurance guy will have a real time with it. See that? Put that thing off. And reset that.
Round it back under this way, but away from the hot water.
And if you got gas piping people coming out there to convert a finish tomorrow or mean to finish, and tell him not to have that drop right above that easy. Have it a couple feet over to the back. Okay.
All right. So we're gonna talk about the components. You got your body, the aluminum body. Some may call it elbow, some call it aluminum body. You have the two orifices inside. Now the D design. You guys might talk about, some of you guys might talk about the old one. The little pressure switch on top with the stainless steel tubing. That's the old design. That's the C design. There's two orifices in there, but those two orifices are two different numbers. You got a 0.44 millimeter and a 0.42 millimeter on a C design. Right. On a D design, which doesn't have that pressure switch on top, the pressure switch is actually incorporated right in here. Alright? So the orifice, the two orifices inside it are the same. They're both 0.44 millimeter. So if you have a D design, which is still a little grab cap, you only need to keep one of those inventory, 0.44 millimeter. If you have the one with the pressure switch or stainless steel tubing, I make sure you have one at 44 and one at 42. This little mechanism, pushing down on the pilot. We used to be able to stock these guys from our previous vendor, not from our new supplier. Okay? They will not sell us this. So if you get one where you try to like the, you place a thermocouple. Push it down and like, oh, the pie keep going up. Yeah, it's that metal, it's that plunger in there. That thing has gone bad, and you just have to replace the whole valve. Okay? Now, one thing when you guys replace this is a straight thread. Alright? So we Loctite it when we put the arm on the factory. So when you go to take it off, don't just try to take it off by force. You're going to break that aluminum body, that soft aluminum here. You need to heat it up a little bit to soften that liquid Loctite. Once you soften it off, you can move that without breaking it off. Yeah. That's one thing that we've been getting a lot of people coming in, trying to take the valve off, either going from a modulating one with the zone counter control to an individual control where the thermostat is mounted right to the unit. And they try to replace it. They take this off and they break the valve without realizing there's actually Loctite on it. So that's one thing you guys want to do is you guys want to replace this with the valve. You have to replace the whole valve. Make sure you soften up this with a little lighter. Soften up the metal. Not the metal. Soften up the Loctite, the liquid Loctite. Once you soften that up, you can pull that up.
We need a Loctite.
It will come with the valve will come with a little pack of Loctite. Right, those green Loctite, I forgot the number is, but the green liquid Loctite. This valve should never have to be adjusted. It's pre-step from the factory. You shouldn't have to take the valve with Loctite down. You shouldn't have to take that out and make an adjustment. Right, so that you shouldn't have to do. Same with the old style. Same with the C design with the pressure switch on top, followed by a tubing. You shouldn't have to make any adjustment on that.
Hey, thanks for putting that up. No, couldn't help with that. On this new design too, with these nut drivers that they've got nowadays on the old style, you had to kind of grind down the nut driver, get it thin enough where you get the orifices off. Sorry. With this one, you don't have to do that. There's enough space. I'll pass it around.
Just be very careful when you put it back in though. It's soft metal, the brass, the hole. You go to go in and all of a sudden you snap it off. Now you're in trouble. Now you can't get that brass off. So just get it nice and snug, get it straight, get it nice and snug in there. You'll feel it when it's stuck in tight. So again, it's a very fine thread in there and it's a male brass. Brass is soft. All right, from the body, we got our thermocouple. All right, now, you're seeing this design out there. You guys will be seeing this design out there. All right. We're going to go with this one. We got some coating back here. Much better job with breaking off here. So then once it breaks off here, you're done. You have to replace the whole thermocouple here. So the newer thermocouple did a better job of sealing and coating that. How many of you guys have replaced this, like, pocket? Your thermocouple.
We don't really work on it too much. But sometimes we get called off that say the Brooders aren't working. So maybe we're working with the monitor on the stone control and just making sure there's enough pressure. The one-off heaters that aren't working, we can identify it that course. Tell them we gotta get it fixed, but we wonder if we do much.
Yeah, talking about zone panels real quick, something we will have in the future, all our zone panels will have a pressure gauge on.
Correct. Right at the end of that oval, and a draft oval, with a plug-in, will be a pressure gauge. So actually look a little different than what we have to have here.
Right, but it'll be a deal where if somebody calls you from farm, says I don't know what's wrong with the zone panel. You can say, walk to the zone panel, do this with the valve, and look in there and tell me what your pressure is. That's an eliminated the trip in there. So,
the original thermocouple is one of those fusible length ones where once you blow it, you have to replace it. This one has an auto reset, the same with the new one that we're getting, it's an auto reset. Once, for some reason, if the plane travel back and heats up here, that sends to this to trip the high temperature breaker here, pretty much a fuse. Right? But it will reset once it cools off. And then you should be able to take run again, find out what any blockage. You know, do we have a bad gasket or no gasket in here? Or the cone? Do we have a blockage in the cone here? Causing that flame to kind of travel back. That's where you can take a look at. I forgot to mention the body has a plate. Alright? That's press plated from the factory. So, you know, if you get one out there and it doesn't look like it's all the way in, somebody try to remove it or somebody did a conversion and then push that all the way in. So we went away from sending that plate out into just giving you the whole body with that press fitted in. All right, so the natural gas is smaller, LP is bigger. All right, so take a look at that when you get out there too. 22 and I think the other one's 14. So you make sure you have the proper plate for the proper gas. Follow there, you got your ventilator tube, the black tube here. That's where the air flows in, meet up with your gas for combustion right in this chamber. All right? A lot of maintenance, you know, go through it, clean them, blow it up, compress the air flow through here. We prefer compressed air, but if you have to, if it's really bad, you need to really wash it out on the modulating unit. You can run garden hose water through here. Alright? So run it through here, let it drain out until you suck in a nice clear water coming out, shake it off. Okay? Once you shake it off, fire it up right away. Fire it up so the heat burns off the water so you don't have oxidation happening. Okay? But we prefer here. If you can get by with air, that's the first thing you want to do. Use compressed air, blow it down. Flip it up, blow back this way, so it works the way back. Do it a couple of times, that should clear it for you. If they do a routine maintenance, shouldn't be that bad. You shouldn't have to use water, just move back here, it'll be fine.
Now, question for you, are these Brooders hanging in the building all the time? Are they still doing that? Are they putting them hallways down red or what?
They're hanging out.
They're hanging all the time. Okay, are they getting bad?
I got bad knowledge. They go through every turn and make sure they work. We replace all parts every turn.
But those Brooders hanging in that building, they get dirty.
They're
I have sometimes they put glass in bags over and try it out.
Yeah.
You used to go, I don't know if they do that anymore.
Sometimes.
Yeah, for some reason, I don't do this over full of water. Yeah. The water is in the bag. You apply it in the
bag. You get the bag, fill it with a bag.
There'll be guys holding on to it, huh?
Well, like, it'll be light.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Well, I think the reason why he did that is because, you put a bag over there, you got a lot of humidity in here. Now you got a humidity sitting in here, now eating away at this. Next time you take it out, it's all rusted. So, he probably just mentioned that, don't do that. Just either take him down.
You know, that guy down there, he's replacing orifices just about every turn. Just because.
Does he have a filter on him?
Yeah. They have a sock on it, but it's just almost standard procedure for this guy. He just goes around all the arms every turn and takes orifices out, puts the orifices in.
Are these naturally ventilated buildings, right?
No, they're curtain. Power ventilated power buildings.
Okay. Because we do see on certain places, where the ventilation's not as good, it's like a natural building. We see the building on the Brooders a little bit worse than other places or other farms.
Now the filter, when he has the filter on it, does he go through it and take them off, flatten them off, get the dust off? No, he just
hides them. Yeah,
but I mean, that filter is basically just stopping that.
You know, he just put one on you every time. I mean, yeah, they gave this guy like $7 or $6 a Brooder to make sure they're on.
So I'm going to wait. What you could do is go through there and pick 5 gallon buckets and take the filters off, stuff them in the bucket, fill up the water, let them soak, and then let them get cleaned out. Just dry them out for a second.
I usually recommend just taking them off, give it a good pat on your leg, you get all the dust built off of it. You're good. Unless it's really caked on, then, like John said, soak in the water, rinse them off, give it a good shake, let them dry, air dry it. Once it dries, put them back on, almost brand new.
Usually after they've been hanging for 4 months with big pigs in there, they need to be washed out.
Or never.
Now, I heard people say, I blow my Brooder. I blow it on to clean.
Yeah, you blow the top off, that doesn't do nothing.
This is where all the magic work. Huh? Yeah, I blow my heater off, I blow the top off. What does that do? Yeah. So, I mean, this is where, you got a lot of dust put up in the cone. You're going to shorten that lifespan of that inner cone. You're going to break that beam, you're going to burn to the tip, now you're going to have to replace that inner cone. Okay? The thermocouple. If you get a lot of dust go up on the outer cone, now you got a lot of heat trapped in here. Thermocouple is going to go out. You're going to have to replace the thermocouple. So, just by saying, I blow the top, I blow my top, I use the leaf blower, I blow it off. You got to go through and blow the top away. In here, through here, a couple of times. That should definitely get all the dust off of these guys. Okay? Now, if you do have an inner cone that does need to be replaced, you will get a new inner cone and a gasket. Alright, that is recommended to replace the gasket whenever you do an inner cone replacement.